Do you consider yourself to be an empathic person? Well, today I'm going to be sharing the 5 traits that almost all empathic people share, and the last one might surprise you. My name is Heather Evans. I'm a self-care and empowerment coach working with empaths and highly sensitive people around the world. If you're ready to live your most empowered life, remember to subscribe to my channel and click on that bell to get notified when I release new videos every week. There are 5 traits almost every empath shares, and I wanted to share them with you. In case you've been feeling a little alone or isolated, I want you to know there are other empaths out there just like you. Let's get started. The first trait of empaths is that we have the ability to pick up on other people's emotions. Now, some might say, yes, I can do that as well. I can read a person and know how they're feeling. But for empaths, it's a little bit different. It's a heightened state of awareness. In fact, it's a heightened state of awareness whereby we can feel what another person is feeling, literally. We might have sensations that course through our body. We might take on another person's emotional states because as empaths, we're open and receptive to empathizing or identifying and being open to other people's states of being. The second trait has to do with our senses and how sensitive we are to things like sight, smell, touch. Because we're empaths, we are more open and receptive to pretty much everything that's around us. Crowds can be overwhelming. Certain smells can be overpowering. Certain sights can be a lot for our system to take in. I often think about it like this. As an empath, I had the experience of deboarding a plane in Las Vegas, and I remember stepping into the airport terminal and feeling bombarded by all of the sights, smells, and sounds that were around me of casino machines and people walking around and lots of noise happening. It became so overwhelming for my system that my system almost went into shutdown, where I felt so overwhelmed that I had to take a few moments to reground myself. And I made sure that when I was staying in Las Vegas, and this was for a work trip, that I put myself in a location that was further away from the usual hustle and bustle that Las Vegas brings with it. Empaths can be highly sensitive to a number of things. Not only are we sensitive to other people's emotional states, we're sensitive to things like smells, sights, and sounds. So we want to be careful with what we ingest. Our systems might be more sensitive to things like caffeine, alcohol, drugs, medications. We want to be aware of what we're ingesting in terms of what we consume online and what movies we watch or what shows we watch, even what podcasts we listen to. All of these things can contribute to feelings of overwhelm in an empath system. The third trait of empaths is that we need time alone to recharge our batteries. Now, this doesn't mean that we isolate ourselves. It also doesn't mean that we're necessarily shy. It just means that in order for us to bring our systems back online after being out and about in the world and spending time with people and doing the things we do, we need time to recharge, and the best way we can do that is by spending time alone, by tuning into what our systems need and honoring that. The fourth trait of an empath, we tend to be givers, and sometimes overly so. As a result of being able to tune so easily and take on so easily other people's emotional states, it can be easy for us to put ourselves aside and then give to others, take time for others, put others in front of ourselves. Now, this is a trait that I encourage every single one of my clients. And if you identify as an empath or a highly sensitive person, I encourage you to do some work around this as well. But to begin to discern what is my side of the emotional, energetic, mental puzzle and what belongs to somebody else. This can help us discern how we need to show up, not only for others, but also for ourselves in healthier ways. So this trait of giving, and sometimes giving overly or overextending ourselves to be there for others, this is one that I work with a lot of my clients on. The last trait of empaths, and this is the one that might surprise you. Most empaths are introverts. However, not all empaths are introverts. In fact, some are extroverted. Now, this is interesting because I think a lot of people might look at an empath and go, oh, they're shy, they're introverted, they want to spend more time by themselves. And nothing could be further from the truth. I have many clients who are empaths who are also extroverted and out in the world and gregarious and all of the things that go along with being an extrovert. I also have a lot of clients that happen to be ambiverts. They're both introverted and extroverted. So while the majority of empaths do identify as being introverted, there are some empaths that are extroverts. I'd love to know if you identify as an empath, and if so, which one of these traits do you identify with the most? Leave a comment below. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did like it, remember to subscribe to my channel and click on that bell to get notified when I release new videos every Monday and Thursday. Stay ignited out there. I will see you soon. Bye.